In my mind, wealth is an emotion. You know, it doesn't really matter how much you have, how much you make. Because I've interviewed over the course of my career, I've interviewed many millionaires and billionaires, and some of them are very unhappy and very upset with everything. I'm sure you've met some happy ones and very unhappy ones. So, and also among the people who are struggling with life, there are also happy people and unhappy people. So, I think wealth is an attitude. If you feel like you're so happy and so content with what you have, you are already wealthy. But if you have, if you have to struggle every day and you cannot find happiness either in your business or in personal life, I think you're not wealthy, even if you have billions in your bank account. But that doesn't mean that you don't have to have money. My mentors have been teaching me so many things about money, but from a very different perspectives, mostly from Zen approach. So it's not Western people tend to think that I need more money to be happy, but instead Zen approach is how can you find satisfaction in what you have? So it's not a matter of how much money you make or how much money you have. It's more about your attitude toward money. And the relationship you have with money gives you happiness or miserable life. So you really have to be careful with what you have. I had this opportunity to meet my mentor later on. His name is Wahei Takeda. So when I asked him to teach about money, he said his first lesson is forget about money. So I was so confused. So I think he meant about where I focus. Because if you want money, you have to forget about money. You have to forget about what you can give to other people, how much service you can give out to the world, and then you receive money. So he was telling me not to focus on money because money is the end result of what we get after serving the world. So instead of focusing on what you get, you have to really focus on what you give. And our life is in the middle of giving and receiving. So unless we receive well, unless we give well, we can receive. So we are in this cycle of appreciation or resentment. Either cycle you're in, your life exists. So if you start appreciating your life about everything, including money, your life will be filled with money and appreciation. If your life will be filled with resentment, anger, and fear around money and also around life, your life will be also surrounded by fear and resentment and anxiety. So he taught me how to focus instead of just getting the end result of money. And he was very well respected because he was talking about philanthropy. The biggest problem, I think, especially today, is that we are so afraid of money. And so, as much as we want money, we are so scared of it. It's because of a money trauma. I call it money wounds that we've had since our childhood. We used to have some. Unless your parents are perfect, and unfortunately, it's not the case in any culture. So we've been scolded about money. You know, we spend too much, we wasted the money, or we denied a karate lesson or soccer lesson or a ballet lesson or piano lessons because it's expensive. Some of my friends were taught, "You are not worth it." Well, that's a big blow. So. We've been denied so many times around money. So that's why, as much as we want money, because we feel money can buy happiness or money can buy at least freedom. But at the same time, money have been abused us for so many ways. So as much as we want to get close to it, but if we get too close to it, we get burns or like hurt. So for a lot of people, money is a mystery person. Start watching your language. My mother used to say that. And then around money especially, a lot of people say like, you know, I was ripped off. So there are so many negative language around money. And my mentor Wahei said, you have to use positive words around money. Otherwise, money will not like you. And I thought it's very cute, you know. And then in my book, I talk about what if money were a person, who would it be like? Is that person a gentle person or angry person? So just, you have to pay attention to how you relate to money. If you just feel like money is just a thing, like you don't care, but if you don't care, you end up being in debt. So you have to be very careful and respectful for money. For some Japanese people, actually one of my students, made futon, bed for a wallet. It's so cute to show respect. While I rest, please, money and credit cards, please rest here too. So it's like a little bed, like a cat bed. And then you're supposed to put your wallet into the bed. So it's just a metaphor. But unless you show respect to money and the money coming in, money going out, both ways, you cannot really feel, you cannot feel peaceful around money, especially this hard time of economy. You have to really pay close attention to your emotions. And most of us are so controlled by anxiety and fear around money. That's why we do things which are not really true to us in order to survive. So we feel like if we have no money, we cannot survive. That means your death. So the funny switch is turned on. I think it's our survival mechanism. 200 years ago or 300 years ago, everybody was a farmer. Nobody's, probably don't use much money. But now, unless you have money, you cannot buy food. So money and survival are so tied in your system. But since we've been abused, we feel like we've been abused by this person. We're a little scared of this person, right? So I think the first step is actually the step that my mentor Wahei Takeda taught me. That is, arigato your money. Thank your money. When money comes in, either by in the form of government check or a salary or commission or whatever the money you receive, you say, thank you, arigato. Thank you, money, for coming in. Because in these days, it's so rare to find you and pay you. Somebody pays you, right? Either could be government or your husband, wife, or your clients. There are so many other people who do the similar job that you do, but they chose you to pay you. So like there are millions of reasons to appreciate for the money. So when money comes in, just say thank you, or arigato, or danke, or seishi, or whatever your language, or merci, And then when you spend money, also arigato, because you're getting something for the money. And Wahei said, arigato in, arigato out. So it's almost like a Karate Kid teaching, wax in, wax out. So he said, arigato in, arigato out, if you do it for 2 months, and then come back. So I wanted to have some stock tips or like investment tips, or I expected something different. But the thing I got is arigato in, arigato out. And I practiced for 2 months, and I felt genuinely happier. So I recommend anybody, just try it at least, because it doesn't cost you anything. And once you start appreciating money coming in, money going out, you start appreciating about other things. So this arigato in, arigato out opens a door to a new life, which is full of appreciation. And I think we definitely need that. Wahei said, appreciation melts fear and anxiety. So if you start and if you keep appreciating money coming and going out, you cannot worry about money at the same time, because a human mind can focus one thing at a time. So Wahei has a very interesting, unique trick changing our wire in our brain. So once you start appreciating, it's so funny because one of my students said, oh gee Ken, I forgot to worry about money for a week because you focus on appreciation. Once you start appreciating, your life shifts too. For example, one of the readers on my book, she was a single mom with a low paying job. She was working as a secretary. And then she came to me and she used to complain about her low paying job. But after reading my book, she changed her attitude and she started appreciating about life and boss. And she realized that she didn't have a college degree, But she was hired as a secretary, so that's a big reason to appreciate her boss. Before, she was always complaining about him. And I think the feeling really probably came across to her boss, and she got a big raise in a few weeks. So once you start appreciating, I've heard so many stories, I can even write a few books on this. Once you start appreciating your boss, your clients, they appreciate you back. So in my 20s, the reason why I was successful was I was a little unique in so many different things. For example, when I was doing accounting consulting, I divided my clients to two groups. One, I do regular job. The other, I always bring something whenever I got to meet them, just a herb tea, Japanese tea, like a book, or just not super expensive. So in 6 months, I got so many referrals from the gift-giving groups. You know, I didn't ask for any clients, right? But they get me so many referrals. And the second, you know, group, not so much. So I recommend everybody to start giving more, something a little extra, not like 30% more, but something to show your appreciation. And it doesn't really matter if you're a florist or cleaners or business lawyers or a dentist. If you start giving something, you get more. So this is the law, I think. If you give more, you receive more. And then there is one more extra reason to appreciate about. So your life would shift. So your whole energy would be so different and so content. And I think people want to do business with happier people. You know, people don't want to go with people who are very depressed. So the people with radiance of appreciation often attracts more people and more opportunities. So this is not a new age or a spiritual thing. It's a practice to appreciate more. So what you appreciate, appreciates. And I think it's so simple. So start appreciating about money is the first step. And then second step is start appreciating what you have. And if you start sharing what you have, I call it gift. All of us have gifts. I've written probably like half of my books, 20 books on how to discover your gifts and monetize them. Because we are born, each of us is born with a special gift and something to be shared with this planet. And if you can find it, and if you can improve it, and you can polish it and just share with a society, I think that translates into money. So I wrote a national bestseller, Do What You Love and Make Sure Money Follows You. So it's very important. You have to have both. In the process of expressing and finding who you are, happy money follows you. So forget about money is that teaching. But you know, at the same time, don't forget it completely. You have to make both ends meet. So that's, you know, I have this accounting consulting background. So I'm a very practical person. So you have to make sure all the bills are paid in appreciation, and at the same time, grow your energy,